today it's the 2th of May, and we are nearly ready to go again and out and cycle. But the weather are really good, the same I was yesterday. I hope it will be good weather and nice weather. So yes, it's really good weather. So,
we have a big bike day today. The longest we've biked so far, 87 kilometers.
87 kilometers. We think the town is name is Pamukkale.
Or Pamukkale, I'm not sure yet.
We don't know.
Have to pronounce it.
Yeah, we need to find out. Yeah. What? See you on the bikes and the road. So, bye bye.
Okay, just leaving the place. We actually arrived here for lunch yesterday and stayed there for 2 hours while we had our lunch, trying to decide what to do. In the end, we decided to cycle down the road, but then we came back after 2 kilometers because it was a big thunderstorm. But, we had a night here. Yeah, the sky looks much better this morning, so that was a good decision. So, okay.
Ready to go here at 8:30. That's the earliest yet. We're not very good at getting up early and getting going, but we're also biking quite late and going later to bed. That's a good start because we've got a long day. So.
This is the town of Nazili that we're on our way through now. Starting here, it's quite a big town, really. Past 9 now, so we're just coming past the town where we're planning to camp. So hotel worked out better because we never would have been on the road at this time of the morning if we were camping. It takes usually 10 o'clock at the earliest by the time we're moving, so that worked out okay. We didn't get wet. We had to put the tent up in a thunderstorm. Now it's just keep cruising down the road. Already, and it's only 9:45, so that's a new record.
Okay, the man here was really kind. He was actually the only one to have water because we don't have so much water. And next thing, the man come over to us and would say, "Would you have some oranges?" And yeah, and so he had given us orange, and so he have takes his telephone and take translator on and say he will give us more fruit in 2 minutes.
Amazing. Just pull up in a petrol station and
it was nice
and
refreshing with
a orange, yeah. Okay, we're not getting too far this morning now. We stopped just for water. And a guy gave us some oranges and he says, "Wait 2 minutes, I'll be back." Now he's been back with some kind of apples. Now the lady in the petrol station says, wait, I'm going to give you some tea." So now he's guy just came back again and says, "Oh, wait 2 minutes more, I'm going to get something else." So it's turned into a big break. We'll see what happens.
Okay. Are there anyone that are seeing our videos that know what this kind of thing is? Because so you can give a comment and say what the fruit is. So that is a little quiz. And the thing is, I will give a little bit of it. It's big. There are some big nuts in it. Ah, it's falling down in here. So. You see when you eat it.
There we have another bag of something, we don't know what it is yet.
Figs.
And figs now, yeah.
And this, does anybody know what this is? You don't know? can try later.
And this is the guy here that gave us this bread. It came all from his garden. So the guy that gave us the fruits here, he said they got it. Everything in Turkey, so it's the best place in the world, but nobody knows about it, he said, so, or appreciates it. So but, he was a kind guy, he worked over in the shop over there, so he couldn't speak any English, but luckily these days we have a thing called Google Translate, so you just talk into the telephone in Turkish and kind of English comes out the other end, so that's quite a good help for us. Thank you, bye bye.
The Coca-Cola men are going and give more cola. You can see the car.
Oh yeah.
What?
Oh yeah, that's another person we spoke to. With. Coca-Cola. Okay, I think we need to get going. Otherwise, it's going to be a long day. Hi, back on the road again after an unexpected long water break, turned into fruit tasting. Nice mosque there, new colour turquoise roof. Already done the first 40 kilometres before 12 o'clock, so going quite good really. Well, we're biking in now, it's known for being an extremely fertile place. We can see it's green all the way down with trees and crops growing. Turned off the main highway there now. Just see it in the distance, I think, over there, the white rocks, I think we can see. So, just done the first 60 kilometres now, only half past one, so that went fast. So, we're sitting here, find a roadside place with a nice burger. So, it's the first time we've been on small roads for the last few days. I should have a bit of peace and quiet, the last 20 kilometers now to Pamukkale. Speed on now because the rain is getting close. You might just be able to get around it before. See some huge lightning strikes over there. Chasing a thunderstorm behind us, but we managed to get here before it started raining. Our longest day so far, 87 kilometers. It's good we decided to take the hotel yesterday without the breakfast, so we did a bit of haggling and decided to have a quick breakfast in the room. That was lucky, otherwise we would have been biking in the rain.
And in thunder and lightning.
Yeah. So that was okay, it wasn't too bad really.
And the white choice.
We did very well.
Yeah. That's the furthest
we are here, and really beautiful. Yeah, and we have never been here before.
And now I think I would like to get in the cafe before it starts raining.
Yes. It's going to start raining.
Yeah. Bye.
Okay, let's go and find a coffee bar and then we'll find a hotel.
So, bye bye.
Okay, I think we need to rush now because it's going to rain.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
So, I'm timed that just right. Now it's raining.
That was the plan, just to get in the coffee shop before it starts to rain. And we managed it.
Yeah,
that worked out well.
Yeah, it worked really well. Extremely well. Now we just sit here and watch the rain before we decide where we're going to stay. So, I've just been asking around with the prices, and once again, a little bit like in Selchuk, it costs nearly the same to stay in the hotel as it does on the campsite. Here you get your breakfast included, so yeah, it's a little bit strange, I don't understand why, but
we don't think that our trip ought to be so luxury with hotels all the time. It would feel a bit more righty for us in a camping site, but when the price is nearly the same, it seems silly to camp.
Yeah.
And we get breakfast here.
Yeah.
We're just sitting here in Pamukkale now, which looks like a skiing slope, but which is actually calcium. I don't know what's that called in English.
Calcium
stone, that's what makes it white, but it looks like snow, but it's not. And we're just sitting here in the restaurant talking about we can't believe how much we have experienced in 2 months. It's only 2 months ago we left our house, and we can't believe how much we've experienced. Completely what shocked by it. And so happy to be here now. So you saw that on the map, and now we are here on our bikes.
So now we're here in Pamukkale. Never been here before, but looks like a nice place. Tomorrow we'll go for a walk up there through the white cliffs there. The thermal pools, some up above there, some other ancient ruins, and the old ancient bath of Cleopatra used to use, so should be good to see. So we'll do that tomorrow and we'll have a day here and see how that goes. I think we need to rush now because it's going to rain.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Turn the screen
I'll
off.
Just film a bit, little bit more. Little
no,
more.
Turn the screen off.
Oh, we need to look at this up
no,
here.
No,
oh,
you little.
There's some trees up there. Oh.
Daddy,
oh,
stop
oh.
Now.
What's the flowers?
No, Daddy.
Okay, let's go.